Good morning, how are you? We are live on ITV from, I've got to say, an actually very nice day here on London's South Bank. And let me tell you right now, if you've got anything planned this morning, cancel it. It's a bit nippy, actually. Do not move from that sofa because we have got, honestly, a brilliant, brilliant show for you this morning. And of course, this show is Sunday Side Up. Come on! Here we go. Look at this for guests. We haven't even started. Right, what have we got on Sunday Side Up this morning? I hear you ask, well, let me tell you. We've only gone and got Matt Willis and Danny Jones from the best supergroup in the world, McBusted! And from those jumps have got a bit lower, haven't they? Yeah. Hey, right. All the back. And from Towie, it's Chloe, Arch, and Diags. Welcome to the show. Welcome to you all. Thank you for coming along today. Do you know what? I'd like to give our guests some presents. So I'm going to start off with the Towie lot. Obviously, I love Towie. But as a lot of you say, you mug. You're a mug. Can you give us a Diags mug?
You mug, exactly.
So look, I've only kind of got you. You mug mugs! Yeah, pass them down, there you go. Look, there Lovely. You are. You've got one each, you mug.
You mug.
Now, let me tell you, we're mugging them off, exactly. But I've got to tell you guys from McBusted, I have got you a very special gift, but unlike any other show, I'm saving it till later on. It is that special. It's not just
my God.
Don't be nervous, honestly. Right, we'd also love to hear from you this morning, so please do get in touch with your comment or the contact info you need is on the website or follow us at Sunday Side Up. There you go, there is the address. Good stuff. And this week, we also need you to take part in our X Factor poll. We want to know the answer to this very important question. Which of the remaining X Factor finalists would you not trust with a secret? Yes. Just go to the website to vote. We'll reveal the result and talk about last night's show just before 11 o'clock. What are you two up to? What are you nudging each other for? What are you two doing? Yes. Now, talking of important questions, it is now time to get the lowdown on this morning's celebrity guest. Floor manager Dave, could I please have my big question cards, please? A bit quicker, Dave. The show's only an hour. Unbelievable. Thank you very much, David. Right, good. Okay. McBusted and Towie, it's time for your big questions. Oh, yeah. Here we go. Right, the first question is for McBusted. You performed on TV for the very first time together on Friday's Children in Need. How was that?
It was great. Do you know, I've not been so nervous about a performance, I think, ever in my life.
It's but, exciting, though,
it was
isn't it?
So exciting. Yeah,
it was unbelievable. It was. It reminded me of when we played our show at the Albert Hall. That excitement we had. It was like little excited kids at Christmas.
Amazing. I'm so pleased. It was amazing. We'll talk about this a bit later on. Towie, the latest series of Towie ended this week. Yes, but you must have had a party to celebrate.
Oh yeah. Yeah. We had a rap party always.
Come on, Chloe, who was the worst behaved?
Arch. It's always Arch.
What was he doing? What was he doing?
Well, he's giving lots of wet kisses to everyone. Making off your whole makeup. Then he's decided to have a dance off, yeah.
All wet kisses.
Which I won.
No. Why are you giving wet kisses? A little
I think no. I always give the girls kisses on the cheeks. They think I'm really cringy and slobbery.
No, he doesn't do it that little. He licks your whole face.
No one likes a wet one. No. But McBusted. Yes. Who's in this photo with you? Let's have a little look. Who is that?
Oh, that's Charlie Quirk.
Who's Charlie Quirk?
Charlie Quirk is he plays my brother in Birds of a Feather.
He's only in Birds of a Feather, everybody. Tell you what, 2014 is looking. It's going to be a good year, isn't it?
Yeah, man, it's shaping up well.
Yeah. I was a massive fan of Birds of a Feather first time round. What's it like to be part of history, really, now?
Yeah, man. I mean, I was a massive fan of that show. Like, my mum watched it religiously, you know, so I grew up with that show. So as soon as I got the script breakdown, I tripped out. You know, I couldn't believe I was going to be auditioning
for it. Who are you in it?
I play Garthy
in the Robson Son.
Yeah.
Oh,
Garthy's back.
Nice. Towie, Arj, I've heard you've got an autobiography out. Come on, I've always got out a quirky man. He's only done an autobiography.
Yeah.
Right, so come on. So what's it going to be called? Like, what's it going to be called?
I don't know. I'm thinking of names at the moment. I'm not too
sure. And Chargy.
Bit of Argy Bargy.
I like that. Argy Bargy's a good one as well.
A bit of Argy Bargy. That's what I like that so far.
And so how far are you into the book?
Well, I've done most of it, yeah.
Have you?
Most of it's
have
done.
You? Yeah. How long has it taken you to write?
Well, Dyer's always takes a mick at me. He's like, chapter one, I ate some. I ate something. Chapter two, I ate some more. Chapter three,
the end.
Got out of bed. No, it will be good. I promise you, it'll be a good read.
Are you going to reveal secrets?
There will be a few secrets. Not too. Yeah. There will be some secrets.
What's the biggest secret you know about someone?
Probably something I can't really say.
But who's it about?
I think we've all got some secrets on each other, haven't we, Chloe?
Yeah. I don't think you've got any secrets. He ain't got any secrets. He tells everybody.
No one tells anything, so I've got the biggest mouth in Essex, apparently.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, apparently,
a bit of a gossip.
Ridiculous.
I like a chit chat.
Apparently, you've got the book in your dressing room, I've been told. The manuscript of it. I'll read that during the break. Right, McBusted. Whose idea was this?
Oh, what,
the
human pyramid.
That was James Bourne's idea. The genius that is James Bourne came up with it. We kind of wanted to do something fun, you know, and something a bit different. And so we decided to do a human pyramid.
Yeah, but I couldn't believe we actually did that on a red carpet.
I love the fact that you all get together, you know, now the biggest super group around. You go, come on, guys, do something fun. What should we do?
Do something fun, but slightly rubbish.
Archie,
here we are.
Have you switched on any Christmas lights this year?
Yes, I switched on some Christmas lights yesterday in Torquay, actually.
Oh, nice. When I think of Christmas lights, it's I think ching ching. Yeah. Do you remember when we turned on?
We did one together, didn't we?
We did one together.
Yeah.
So the Lord Mayor's there, everything's great. Big countdown 10, 9, 8, get down to 1. Press the button.
The light.
One light.
It was a disaster, wasn't it? It was an absolute
disaster, and then we literally just went, come on, let's just go.
It was so embarrassing.
Well, listen, thank you very much, Bookbusted and Towie. Those were your big questions. There we are. Right. Well, let me tell you, coming up in part two of Sunday Side Up, one of you, it could be you, will be making strange noises on the end of a phone when we play Sofa Superstar, and we'll be talking about last night's X Factor. And don't forget to take part in our poll. We wanted to know which of the X Factor finalists would you not trust with a secret? Just go to our website to cast your vote, and we'll see you after the break. Welcome back to Sunday Side Up. Now, if you're a massive fan of Busted, yeah, and Towie, then you've come to the right place, because our very special guests this morning are Matt and Danny, plus Chloe, Arj and Diaz. Now, during the week, we asked you to send us a photo to prove how excited you are about the birth of McBusted. Now, the first one is from Claire and Louise, everybody.
Hello, Claire and Louise.
Let's take a little look at them. These are photos from 2004 to the present time. Look, a nice little collage.
Nice.
Nice little montage there for you. Very nice. Thank you very much. We do love a montage. Next up is Sarah and Brogan. Hello, Sarah and Brogan. Let's have a little look at them. Look, they are very excited at the front.
Yes.
And they're going to see McBusted tour in May.
They're coming to see you, boys.
Nice. And finally, we've got Morgan and Danny. Hello, Morgan and Danny. Hello to you. Let's have a little look at the picture. Oh, it's you, Danny. You look more excited than she does.
What?
When was that?
Me?
You look fantastic, Danny.
Yeah, look,
there it is. Yeah. When was that?
Well, clearly a long time ago. Thank you very much for sending those in. And if you want to get involved in the show, then check out our website. And you can even follow us, if you like, at Sunday Show TV. And that's exactly what you need to do to play our phoning game. Now, we only need Matt and Arj for this. So, Arj, if you'd like to come over here. The other guys, you can egg from the sidelines or grab a cup of tea, whatever you need to do. Just get out. That's it. Lovely. the sweets. Danny's nicked some sweets from there. They've been there from week one. Right. It is time for Sofa Superstar. Welcome to the game for people who love noises but hate prizes. Just like this week's caller, it's Naomi from Monmouth. Hello, Naomi.
Hello, good morning.
Good morning. You sound very happy. How are you?
I've had lots of caffeine.
Have you? Oh, please, you, if you said that. OK, let's have a little look at Naomi. There she is, look. Very nice. Look at Naomi. Wait, no, you're looking very good there, Naomi. You look
Thank you.
Like Marty McCutcheon.
Thank you.
Yeah, very nice. OK, so tell us something about yourself, Naomi, that's going to make everybody here and at home go, wow!
OK, this is going to make you go wow, and I think be a little bit envious. I'm a member of the Emmerdale fan club, and I've recently been on an Emmerdale weekend where I got to see the studio sets and hang out at the village itself.
Oh, yeah. Wow! Yes, that's a big wow from Matt. There we are. Right, Naomi, tell me, who do you like best, McBusted or Towie?
McBusted.
Oh, yeah. Gutted, Arch. Gutted.
Your face, Arch. Your face.
Sorry, Arch.
Right, the rules of this game are very simple. We've given Naomi a list of sound effects and theme tunes, and all Matt and Arch need to do is guess what they are. Now, our reigning sofa superstar is Charlotte. There she is. There you are. She loves, I tell you what, she loves Twitter, don't you, Charlotte? She's always on it. Charlotte got a score of 7, but if Naomi beats that, then her photo, this photo here, will take pride of place. Oh, yeah. Just up there. That'd be very exciting. Now, Naomi, as is traditional, do you have a sob story that you'd like to share with us all?
Oh, I do, yes.
Oh, no, go on.
Well, it's a Sunday, traditional roast day, and being a veggie, I thought I'd make a nice nut roast. For my Sunday roast.
Nice.
But
what could go wrong?
I have no nuts. Oh, I forgot to buy them.
What? No, oh. Naomi has got no nuts.
Oh, epic fail.
Oh, epic fail. There you go. Right, let's give everyone. Let's What's giving you the giggles?
Also, no, I don't know. I've got to be careful what you're saying, yeah.
Right, let's move on. Right. Let's give everyone a chance to tune up with a quick practice. Here we go. Oh. What is this sound effect here? Over to you, Naomi. Go for it.
Rabbit. Rabbit.
Oh, it's a frog with a cough.
With a cough, exactly. It's just, it literally is.
Oh, is it that easy?
That simple.
It's that easy, right? Okay. I was overthinking this.
Right. Okay. Remember, it could be a sound effect, a famous theme tune, or are you ready? Just for 1 week only, it could be a classic busted track.
Oh
yes! Oh yes! Right, Naomi, you have 1.25 minute / 75 seconds on the clock, and your time. Start now. Go for it.
Oh,
Tarzan.
Tarzan, well done.
Yes.
Next one. Chloe does it. Loads of girls do it on Towie.
Waxing.
Wow. Oh, waxing, yes, well done. Jim. Next one.
La 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 la.
That's what I got school for.
Well done. Yeah, well done. Next one. Next one.
Arch is all over me.
What's this one?
That's your song.
Number 4. What is that?
Ping pong.
Nope.
No.
You have to turn it off.
Yes. Tap.
What sort of tap?
Off.
No.
A dripping tap.
A dripping tap. Next one.
Do 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 do.
The Simpsons.
Simpsons. Yes. Next one.
A machine gun.
Yes. Next one.
Do 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 do.
New 3000.
Yes. Next one.
Do 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 do.
You should know this one, Arch.
The only way is up.
The only way is up. The only way is Essex. It's your show. Next one.
Laughing dog.
Oh, do you know something? It was Oh, to be told, can't give you that. He's a tickle dog. Oh! But before we announce, how many you got right, the only way is up.
I didn't hear it. You said you should know it, so I thought it was a theme tune to The Only Way Is This. The Only Way Is Up.
That is the music. That is correct.
Give him that one. Give him that one.
Well,
it's a theme tune.
Naomi, don't push it.
And I think he got the last one too.
Excuse me, Naomi. I thought you said you preferred McBusted. Which side are you on?
Now.
Can I tell you now? Are you ready for this, Naomi? Right. You needed seven. You needed to beat seven to get up there. You got eight! Yeah! Well done to you. Which means we need to sadly take Charlotte down. Charlotte, see you later,
sorry,
alligator.
Charlotte.
There you go. And we pop you. There you are. Look at that. Are you happy with that, Naomi?
Oh, I'm very happy.
Very good indeed. Now, before we go, before you go, in fact, would you like to say hello to anyone this morning?
I would indeed. I'd like to say a big...
Oh, she didn't try. What a shame. Right, next week it could be you on the phone. So if you want to take part, go to the Sunday Startup website and look out for Sofa Superstar. Right, Danny, Chloe and Dykes, get yourself back in here. There you go, welcome back. Because it's now time to talk telly. Yes, it is. There you go. Sit yourselves down. Now, I was watching X Factor last night. I noticed you were at X Factor last night.
I was, yes.
It's a very different thing being there, isn't it? I always say this, but when you watch it at home, it looks massive.
It does look massive, but it's not that big.
No.
No.
Who was the best for you last night?
The best was Sam Bailey. Like, I've never heard a live vocal like it. She's
incredible,
she
isn't she?
Is absolutely flawless. It was incredible.
I just love her nickname, which I say every week, Screwbo. Genius.
Screwbo.
Yeah, that's her nickname, yeah. Right, now, I know it always seems like I give Sam Callaghan a hard time, but last night, I've got to say, I thought he did brilliantly.
3, 2, 1, go! Sam is winning, Sam's winning, Sam is winning.
He won the ice skating! Yay! Well done, Sam. Well done, you. Now, although it wasn't all good news for Sam fans, because he did tell us a huge lie during last night's show.
Well, I guess it would be nice if I can touch your body. I know not everybody has got a body like you.
I'm not a karaoke singer.
Yeah. That's right, Sam. That's right, Sam. You're not a karaoke singer. Arj is the best audience in the world. He just laughs at everything. I love it. I love it. And finally, I was watching The X Factor last night while I was eating my dinner, and I was really enjoying my food until this happened.
Nikki Blue Eyes, my Nikki Blue Eyes. If I could have you sing to me every day, I would. Your voice is so soothing and calming. I can't wait to buy your album, really.
Right, it's time now to announce the results of this morning's Sunday Startup Poll. We wanted to know which of the X Factor finalists you would not trust with a secret. OK, Danny,
yeah.
Who would you not trust out of all of them?
Can I have a judge?
Yeah, if you want to.
Yeah, I'd say Sharon.
Oh, why?
Just because I think... No, it's nothing against her. I just think she'd let it out by accident.
Mm.
She'd get overexcited and be like, and then forget.
Yeah. Louis loves a gossip as well, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Louis loves a gossip, yes. What about you, Dykes?
I was going to say Louis, but yeah, go on, you've got it covered. Louis.
which one of the finalists, though, would you pick to not trust with a secret? Chloe.
Come on, Chloe.
Oh, no, I trust them all.
Oh, come on. There must be one that you go,
oh. Fine, I wouldn't tell any of them my secrets.
Go on, then, I'll just let you have it. Who would you pick? And you've got some secrets coming out in your book.
I don't know.
Sam Bailey, I'd say.
Yeah,
Sam Bailey, you wouldn't trust her?
Because mum's gossip, don't they? And they'd like, so...
Excuse me? Thank you.
Oh, it's all kicking off. Right, the Sunday Startup viewers, yes, you decided the least trustworthy finalist was... Sam, look! Sam Callaghan. 24% he got. The audience would not trust Sam Callaghan. Why do you think that is?
He seems trustworthy.
He seems trustworthy. Yeah. At least he's got something.
Yeah.
But the finalist you would trust most is actually Nicholas, 16-year-old Nicholas. You trust him 3% he got, so he's got a good voice as well. 16. Do you know, interestingly, right, because I do watch the show and I love the show, I think he should have entered maybe a year or two later, but he's a bit older. I think he'd stand more of a chance. Yeah.
Mm. I don't know. I think people like the fact he's so young, don't they?
Do you?
Yeah. Isn't that the appeal?
What do you think, Chloe, from a girl's opinion? Is he too young?
Well, I don't know.
Brilliant.
I'm asked about him.
Right. And of course, don't forget the X Factor is back tonight, live at 8 o'clock on ITV with Miley Cyrus. So make sure any young children or elderly relatives are safely tucked up in bed before that starts. Still to come this morning, but Busted will be taking on TOWIE in a showbiz quiz. And while we take a break, why don't you check out what happened last week when it was Corrie versus Emmerdale in a battle of the soaps. It's all on the website. We'll see you back here in just a minute. How are you? Hope you're enjoying the show. Welcome back to Sunday Startup. It's nearly 11 o'clock on your Sunday morning, and we are live here on ITV now. 11:30, Kay, Nadia and Jeff Brazier will be here to tell us what's going on in today's Sunday Scoop. That's after our show. But before that, it's time to catch up with our very special guests. It's Matt and Danny from Busted and Chloe Argentines from TOWIE. I love this bit because I get time to actually have a chat with you, proper chat to talk about what's going on. Yeah. The supergroup, how did this come about? If you just switched on, by the way, very quickly, if you have just switched on, there's the picture there. McFly are joining up with Busted. McBusted now. Yeah. It's going down a storm.
Yeah, I mean, I think it all come about really when we were doing some Royal Albert Hall shows for our 10-year anniversary. And Matt and James came on as like a special guest, I suppose. And then we were like, this is awesome. Let's do more of it. And we never looked back. I mean, it's just amazing. It's gone absolutely through the roof. We've had the best couple of days ever.
I was looking on Twitter and that's gone nuts as well.
Yeah, it's unbelievable.
Yeah, man. I mean, we really didn't know what to expect, but I don't think any of us expected quite this response. You know, it's just been nuts. I mean, we just keep adding more dates to the tour and it's just getting bigger and bigger.
You actually announced at 10 o'clock this morning, didn't you? Is that right?
At 10 o'clock. At 10 o'clock this morning, we announced four more dates. We just added four more dates, but they go on sale. I know. They go on sale tomorrow morning at 9 a.m.
You can do the accent, can't you?
Oh right, okay. You can do. So we've got one in Birmingham, one in Liverpool,
one in Newcastle, and one in Nottingham. Is that Nottingham?
Yeah.
Terrible. I apologise. Please, people from those areas, still buy tickets to our tour.
Is it true that One Direction are massive fans?
Yeah, man. Like, I mean, Louis and Niall have both tweeted me in the past, kind of saying that that we were kind of one of their first gigs and stuff. So, yeah, it's nice. It's nice, isn't it?
That's how old we're all getting.
I know. Believe it.
But you have actually toured with McFly before, both of you, but now...
I mean, we're really close mates. We all toured together when we were first out, you know. McFly supported Busted and we all had a great time.
Yeah, the reason why we're here now is because of the Busted tour and all that. It was amazing. And we all write songs together and we're friends. It's
kind of a no-brainer, really. It was kind of like, this sounds like a good idea.
Yeah. Yeah.
Why didn't we think of this before?
This doesn't feel weird.
There's only one thing. Isn't that lovely? Yeah.
See, this feels fine.
Fine. You wait till I give you my surprise.
All right.
Seriously, big time. There's only one thing missing from the supergroup, and that is me.
You can join anytime.
I've often thought that, Stephen.
You've sat at home thinking we need the Malone. That's what we need. Is Charlie? Is there any talk of him coming back or?
I've talked to Charlie quite a lot recently.
Oh, he's talked to Charlie!
I mean, we're friends, you know, we're friends with Charlie. You know, Charlie's not ready to do this yet, you know, but you know, the door's always open, maybe one day, who knows?
Charlie, if you're watching the show, mate, your loss. Okay, this is very exciting as well. This is so important, I've actually written it down. 10 years ago today, I don't even know if you know this, 10 years ago today, Busted were number one with Crash the Wedding.
Oh, yeah!
So there you go. Happy anniversary to you.
Thank you very much.
And you'll be back in the charts soon. With what?
Yeah, well, at the minute, we've got a new single called Love Is On The Radio. It's a McFly track. And then, yeah, I'm sure we'll be writing on tour. And, you know, if we write something amazing, then we...
Is how close you all are, because James is upright from Busted.
Yeah, he co-wrote our new single. Yeah, yeah.
This is all interlinked, isn't it?
Yeah, it's amazing.
It's very incestuous,
yes. Now, talking of that... here is your gift. Now, we've all heard of a onesie and we've all seen live on television how close the guys are. So, we've only gone and bought, seriously, a twinsie.
A twinsie!
Have you heard about a twinsie? Have you heard about these?
I haven't. My wife once bought me a onesie for Christmas and I told her to take it back. So, I'm gathering a twinsie is going to be worse.
Emma, I know you're watching. Matt's wife, lovely Emma Willis.
If you jump in that first,
you get in that. That's it. You get in first. That's it.
I get in first.
Yeah, get in first. That's it. That's it. Pop it on. That's it. I'll get round here whilst you're doing that. And if you've just switched on, you're literally just watching someone getting a onesie. That's entertainment, isn't it? There you go, that's it. And then Danny, you make sure, that's it. Pop then, Danny, you get in there as well.
All right.
This is not a joke. This is actually on the market. You share that leg. Share that leg. That's it. Share that leg.
Come on, mate. There you go.
That's it. And then pop the other leg in as well. I'm just going to move this. You'll see why. In just a moment.
There you go.
Right, now, let's move on to the towie. That's it. Just pop that, rest that on. Very good. Whilst you're finishing that off, that'll be a lovely thing. Right. Towie, zip. Don't zip it all the way up, because we won't need you, but zip it up a bit. That's it, so we get the effect. There you go. Lovely stuff. There you are, twinsie! How about that? Now, you need to stay in that, please, for the rest of this part. Very good. Sit yourselves down and enjoy yourself. Don't share everything, come on. So, Towie, it was the last episode of the 10th series.
Yeah.
10 series.
10 series.
Wowee. So, how has it all been? What do you do when you're not on the telly? Why are you laughing, Dykes?
Nothing, really.
You don't do anything?
No, I've not really got much going on at the moment.
Dykes likes to party.
Yeah, I like going out. But then that's only the
night. Socialising.
So you literally do nothing?
No, like, I'm busy.
Doing what?
you just went, got nothing going on.
I go shops and that and... out and about.
What a lovely life.
Yeah, it's good.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, maybe you could be an artist. Because we saw you you both.
Yes.
Doing some very nice drawing. Tell us about that for those that didn't see it.
We drew a naked lady. in front of other people. But trying to get girls. But obviously, we didn't realise they were going
to
be naked.
Yeah, we attempted to go to life drawing class because we thought there'd be a lot of girls there. So we went there, and the girls weren't too impressed with us, with our art or us.
Well, do you know something? I've got to be honest. If you haven't seen it, this really, really made me laugh. Have a little look.
Guys, the thing is, we've got to show, you know, women that we can be quite serious, take ourselves seriously, that we're mature. Because
don't look at me, mate.
Being immature is quite unattractive.
Right, okay, but if you'd like to go and stand over there and take your robe off.
Going to get yourself into a nice, comfortable position.
It's hard, mate. We're meant to be serious.
Take a look at Bea and how she's standing.
Come on, Nigel, I'm trying to draw.
Try not to draw what you think you can see.
I'm not concentrating.
What do you think? You two are brilliant. You'd make a great double act. You should think about that.
Yeah.
You should. Now, Chloe, we need your help here, because I know the boys have got a calendar out. We love a calendar here on Sunday.
Oh, no.
What's the match?
Right. Yes. Do you know what? I hate this.
This is their calendar. Ready for Christmas. What a treat for that to be in your stocking. So, we're going to show you some pictures, Chloe, and we'd like marks out of 10 if you would. Okay. First up, let's have a look here. We've got Tom Pierce. There's Tom. Giving it some there. Out of 10, what would you give him there?
Got to give him a 10 out of 10.
Got to give him a 10 out of 10. Very nice indeed. Dyax, of course, you're in there as well. You're one of the guys on the show. Let's have a little look at Dyax. There he is.
His body don't look like that. That is the biggest airbrushing I've seen. I've never seen airbrushing like anything like it.
Would you say that looks like your body?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Spot, spot on.
I love that.
Yeah, it's spot, all good. All good. Suck that in.
And of course, Ard, you were in it as well. You know,
everyone else has got touched show up this. An airbrush. Mine just got show left this. Exactly how the photo was taken.
No, you're kidding. Have a look. are you being serious? They didn't touch yours up.
Everyone else, even Diane, just got touched up, all nice, fancy. Mine, the picture is exactly the same.
You'd never know.
No,
you can't tell. OK, Joey Essex, this is very exciting. Joey Essex, he is going into the jungle. We can see him there. I didn't realise that you were related.
Yeah.
Yeah, so cousin. What is he to you?
My cousin.
Your cousin. How do you think he's going to do? Honestly.
I think he's going to win, definitely. Yeah. I've given him a good, like, talking to and said to him, don't come back if you don't win.
Oh. There you go. Very stern. Yeah. Very strict. What about spiders and bugs and all that sort of stuff?
He's petrified, so I don't know how he's going to get on, really. I'm just being, like, enthusiastic.
But he's got such a good personality, that could really help him.
Yeah. No, he's funny, but he's frightened of everything, so...
What about the food? What's he like with the food?
He's really fussy with food, isn't he?
Oh, yeah. No. So that's why I couldn't do it. But Matt, of course, former king of the jungle.
Yeah!
What advice would you give him if you had any advice at all?
If I had any advice at all to give him, you know, I'd say just go for it. Yeah. You know, the more you put in, the more you get out.
You know, I was saying it with a bit hot in here.
Well, words of wisdom, the more you put in, the more you get out. There you go.
Yeah, yeah.
There you are. Now, let's see what you put in way back when. This is very exciting. When I saw this clip earlier on, before we came on air, it actually brought back such good memories. Would you like to see a bit of classic Busted? Would you like to see a bit of classic Busted?
Yeah!
Would you?
Yeah.
Would you? OK. Are you ready? That's what I'm gonna do. You just know the words. Everyone sing along. Diane, you were singing along there. Yeah. And the jump, the classic jump.
Yes.
Yep.
Amazing. Do you know what, guys? I'm going to recue the music. In the Twinsy, can we see that jump one more time?
Yeah.
Come on, exclusive.
I think we can do that.
Somebody sign up. Come on. So you can do this, guys. We'll play the music. So we'll get it nice and pumpy on the floor.
If we put this leg out,
get ready.
This one back, we won't fall in love.
OK, cool. Okay.
Right, get ready. Let's play the music now. Here we go. Get ready. That's what I do. Yes! Give him a bigger round of applause than that. Oh, do you know something? What good sports, honestly. And if you just tuned in, that really did just happen. Yes. But playtime is now over, people. It's time to get serious. It's time for the Sunday roast. Myself and Danny keep going, it's getting really hot, and I keep forgetting that you are in that. Right, in this week's Sunday Roast, McBusted are going head-to-head with the Towie Lot, and the winner will get their hands on this stunning trophy.
Oh, wow.
McBusted Towie will be facing a number of random questions, but whoever has the most points when they hear this noise will win the game. And when it comes to awarding points, I've got to tell you, you know this by now, my decision is absolutely final. Right. Yeah. Let's take a look at the categories on today's Sunday Roast. There they are. Mulholland's Magic Dance has got you all going on Twitter. It could be coming up today. Where's it going to stop? Nobody knows. Catchphrase.
I love it.
Yes. Right. This question actually was inspired by Arch, who actually said to me, when I saw you this morning, what did you say? You said, I'm amazing at catchphrase.
Yes.
He's amazing at catchphrase. You want to come on the show and hopefully, well, it's a Christmas special.
You never know.
So we'll find out how good Arj is in just a moment. Very kindly, the team at Catchphrase got Mr. Chips to have a dig in the vault and find something we didn't get round to using in the last series, right? You'll get your go in a minute, Arj, but Danny, this one is for you. Ooh. And it's worth 59 points.
Wow.
Good luck. All right. Can you guess what this catchphrase is here? Play along at home as well. Here it comes. What do you think of it? Just say what you see.
Riding the shotgun.
What is it? What did you say?
Riding the shotgun.
He's got it. There you go. Riding shotgun. There we are. Congratulations to you. Well done if you got it right at home as well. 59 points in the bank. Right. Unfortunately, the next two catchphrases are something that we've just cobbled together ourselves, so it's a bit of a hash job. However, to make things a bit easier, they are both classic TOWIE sayings, OK? Keep an eye out for Mr. Chips as well. He's had a bit of a fake tan, especially for the occasion. Arch, this one is for you, and again, 59 points up for grabs. What is this catchphrase here?
Bang out of order,
straight in there. You said you were good at it. Right, now. And finally, this is for both teams, all right? Just all shout right. out when you know the answer. Now, I've got to be honest, we can't afford buzzers, so you need to make this noise by yourselves when you think you know the answer, OK? So remember, it sounds like this. That's very nice. Diags? Right, OK. What is this catchphrase here? Remember, so the noise before you shout in. Just see it and say
well,
it.
Joe. Oh,
noise.
Well, gel.
Yes. He's absolutely right. Look, there you go. There's the well and there's the gel. Congratulations. You just got yourself another 59 points. Well done. Let's go back to the Sunday roast ball, please. What is the next category going to be? Could it be Mulhern's Magic Naked Dance? You know you want it. Oh, let's get ready to jungle. Now, this game is for both teams. Obviously, I'm a Celebrity, starts tonight, cannot wait. And seeing as both teams have got, like, a connection with the jungle, Matt, of course, being former King of the Jungle, and Joey Essex is on the show this year, we've got a very special challenge indeed. But instead of a bush tucker trial, we've got a breakfast trial. Ooh. Oh, yes. Is everybody hungry?
Yes. Yes, Darby.
Yeah, OK, 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 right. Can we have our first challenge, please? Floor manager Dave. Here he comes. Nicely done, David. That's it. Well done. Right, on this tray, we've got 5 glasses of fresh and healthy tomato juice and 1 glass of fresh and healthy tomato juice with an extra ingredient. Let me tell you what it is. This is so serious. I've got to put a glove on. It's not a joke. Admit it, I wish I'd tried the glove on before we went to air. That'll do, right. Yes, one size fits all. Right. It is this. It is a Scotch bonnet chilli. There you go. Matt and Diags will take it. What? The gloves. I know.
It's a really attractive hand you have there.
Look at it. Right. Matt and Diags will take it in turns to pick a glass from the tray and down the drink. Whoever avoids the chilli will bag themselves 920 points. All right? Sweet. Are you ready? Good. And I've got to say, seriously, I've got to say this, do not try this at home. It can kill a man. Diags, you're first. Right.
Okay. What?
Pick a glass, Diags.
Good, Diags.
Where are you going to go?
I'll go this one.
Right. Ooh. And then just down it in one. You must down it in one.
Sure.
Has he got the chilli? Clearly not. Okay, trust me. You'll know when you've got the chilli.
No,
believe me, we were testing it before the show started. Right, Matt, you're up next, wherever you want to go.
Oh, sorry, Matt, I'll come with you.
That's
okay.
Here we go. Right, down in one. In one. Has he got it? No, he's safe. He's safe. This is no joke. It's in there. It's in one of them. Diags. Diags is slightly beefing up now.
Good right. Diags, get in there.
Where's he gonna go? He's got a sweat on.
Oh,
Chloe's enjoying
don't
it.
Don't
look.
Do that one, don't right. do that one.
Is that the one? Go for it, in one.
Down it.
No, he's safe. Right, three to go. OK, one of them does have the scotch bonnet in. Go for it. This is not... I tell you, this couldn't have got any better. We are now down to 50-50, right? Unless, of course, we forgot to put the chilli in. Pick one and go for it.
Come on, Diane.
You've got to go for it. You've got to go for it. Just go for it. Go on. One. Is it the one? Is it the one?
No.
No! Are you serious? What? Are you serious? Well, clearly it's not burning. Matt,
so does this
you
mean
need to go
I
for
still
it.
Have to drink it?
Yes, you need to go for it. That's the rules of the game. That's the rules of the game. You've got to go for it. You've got to go for it. Go for it, Matt. You can do it.
I've had worse in my mouth.
Oh! Yes. Why did I simply think it wasn't going to be hot?
It is hot, isn't it?
Yeah.
Right. And you know, the lovely thing is, what we realised this morning, do you want some water? Are you all right?
I'm all right.
You're OK, good.
I'm all right.
What we found this morning, we did it with one of the runners, and literally, as the afternoon went on, it got hotter.
It's got a lot hotter since already.
Good. Right, now, Chloe, don't think that you are avoiding our breakfast challenge, because for 506... Look at Matt's face. For 506 points, we need you to identify something using just your sense of taste, OK? How confident are you with this? Got a good sense of taste? Yet.
I don't know.
Well, we're going to soon find out. Right. For it, you do need an apron. So you need to pop that on. If we can pass it down, boys, if you don't mind. That's it. And also, Matt is actually... Look.
Such a touch.
Getting some milk or something. Right. Can you pass that down as well? Arch, just pop that on if you don't mind. That's it. There you go. Just pop that on.
Loads of stains,
yes, please. That's it. You don't need to... you don't need to do it up. That's it. Just pop it over.
That's do it, it. Nice.
That's good. Right, OK, whilst that's happening, Chloe, it is time for breakfast. And for this, I need this here. And all you've got to do, don't forget, is just identify the two delicacies that I will be feeding you. OK, you'll be fine. You'll be absolutely fine.
Oh, my God.
Oh, no, what is it?
OK. That's all right. So, that is what is going to be coming towards you in just a moment.
You'll like it.
But don't worry. And also, I'm going to make it even. Don't worry, Chloe. Keep the blindfold on, you'll be fine. Right, that's it.
Every morning.
You'll like it.
You'll like it. I promise.
Nice. The first one's nice.
Right, get ready. Okay.
It's yummy.
Yum, yum, yum. Right. So all you need to do is pop that in your mouth.
Oh, I don't know.
Don't worry, you'll be fine. Oh, just poke your tongue out.
No, I don't think
you'll be fine. I promise.
I'd rather smell it.
You have my word. Poke your tongue out.
Go on, Chloe.
No, it stinks. No, you'll be fine.
You have my word. Just have a little lick.
On the banter club.
Have a little lick.
Lick it. Did you taste it? One more little lick, and then we'll show you.
You're really freaking me out. This is a Sunday morning. I don't need this.
One more little lick, and then we'll let you have a look.
Stinks. What is it? I'm not. I'm out.
Give her a round of applause. It was only octopus.
Oh! It's all the juice.
You'd have liked that. Had a good old little lick. Right, back to the Sunday roast board, please. What is going to be the next category? What will it be? Nobody knows. Where is it going to stop? Oh, the SX Factor. Ooh. And this is for you, Arch. Right, it's not only a chance for Arch to earn some points, but also to earn some cash as well. Yeah. Arch, you fancy yourself as a singer, don't you? You like singing?
For a laugh, yeah.
Yeah, you like singing. Well, we're going to put these singing skills to the test. Danny and Matt, yes. We need you to add some musical accompaniment, if you would like.
No problem.
If you'd all like to follow me over this way here, that's very good indeed. That's it. Come out this way. That's it. Be careful in the twosie, boys. That's it. There you are. Come over this side. That's it. Arch, love you. Right. OK. This is what we're going to try and do live on ITV right now. OK. I'm going to give you a megaphone, Arch.
Let me give you this just here.
There you go, mate. That is for you. Boys, if you'd like to come over this side, grab any instrument of choice that you would like. You stand in the corner just there.
How do you turn it on?
You just, or you literally just talk into it. Bit more.
Hang on. Go. RG, one, two.
Yeah, we're fine.
Oh, it's on.
It's on.
RG, RG.
How'd you turn it on?
Do it one, again. Two. Oh, it's not.
And press that. Do it again.
Hello. Hello.
Anyone would think it was live. But you keep playing with that. So what's going to happen is he's going to sing the song My Way, OK? When he sings My Way, he's going to sing it to all of the people that are walking down on the South Bank. Now, just over there, we've placed a hat. Okay, we've placed a hat just there. There it is. You can see it now. And what he needs to do is try and get as much money as possible.
Hello.
Oh, there we go. We're laughing. Right. So you do the music. We'll also give you a bit of a backing track as well to help the boys out. You sing that and try and get people to put money in the hat. Good luck. Every penny you get will be worth a point. Let's have the music, please. Right, get ready.
Can I have some money, please?
Well, you got to sing.
Oh, sorry.
Can't just beg. That's...
And now the end is near.
Tell me to put some money in a hat.
Can I have some money in a hat?
And so I face the final curtain.
Tell me to put money in a hat.
Money in a hat, please, please.
My friend, I'll say
this. Come on, tell me to put some money.
Can I have some money in a hat, mate? Please, got some money. Lovely. Come on, you, yeah.
Of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full.
There's a hat there. Can you put some money in it?
What is he going to do it?
Yeah, come on, mate. Don't shake your head. Oh, he's a little softly geeked up.
Much more than this. Right.
Whilst Art tries to get some money into his hat to try and win
points. There's a hat there, mate. Can you put some money in it?
We'll add up what he gets if he gets anything. And I'll tell you who's going to win in just a moment. Yeah. Live here on Sunny Side. Tell him to put money in it. See you in a minute. Put money in a hat. How are you? Welcome back to Sunday Startup. Hey, Nadia and Jeff Fraser will be here in just a moment with Sunday Scoop. If you haven't seen it, it's brilliant. But first, we need to announce the winner of today's Showbiz Quiz. Now, before the break, we witnessed a unique moment in TV history. Arj doing some very long-distance busking. It was amazing.
The end is near.
Tell him to put some money in a hat.
Can I have some money in a hat?
And so I face... the final curtain.
Do you know what's never ever before done on TV and never will be done again? Now, we promised to convert any money Arj earned into points, and I've got the very cap here and I've had a little count up. I can tell you, you actually got nothing from the street. But we have had a whip round in the studio and we've got 39 pence. Yeah. Which, which we convert into points. Another 39 points for you.
Lovely.
There you go. Well done. Right, it is time for the final scores. Can we have some dramatic music, please? Mm. Busted. You got 59 points.
Ooh.
Towie, you got... 1,077 points! Yeah!
Well
done. Yes! 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 And then our crew just went, I don't want to go home. Oh, look,
how many points does this get?
What's that?
It's twinsy.
You do. Let me tell you. I'll tell you now. I am going to put that on eBay. That's twinsy. I am. I get lost.
I'm going to smell it anyway.
Please, let's hear it. They've been brilliant. From Matt and Daddy from McBusted. Plus, Polly Argentina from Towie. See you later, guys. Off you go. See you later. There you are. I loved it. I loved the walk in the twinsy.